Very good afternoon. We have with us Dr. Arun Patil. He is the principal of Bharti Vidyapeeth College of Engineering, Lavle. Very good morning. Good morning, sir. And a hearty welcome to you on behalf of College Dunya.
Yeah, good morning, Jovin.
Thank you so much, sir, for sparing your precious time to be a part of the Thoughts on Education initiative by College Dunya. So, sir, let's start with the interview. First of all, sir, being in the education sector, so I have a question directly at that. So you have held key positions at educational institutes throughout your professional career. So what do you think are the key factors that keep you connected with the education sector in particular?
In Bharti Vidyapeeth, I'm working for almost 30 years. So my education career started with Bharti Vidyapeeth, and I'm still continuing in Bharti Vidyapeeth. See, the thing is that teaching is in my blood. It's a legacy for me. My father, mother, maternal grandfather, uncle, all of them are working in teaching profession. And maybe because of that, it's a passion for me to be in teaching. And now I have got opportunity to build the future of the engineers as the role of the principal. And this is the most motivating factor, and it keeps me connected with the educational sector.
All right, sir. So, being the principal of Bharti Vidyapeeth, sir, what is your philosophy of leadership? I mean, how would you describe your leadership style?
Yeah, it's if we say the theoretically, there are certain leadership styles as autocratic, democratic, and delegated. But the fact is that nothing works as a wholesome style. The reason is that you need to have a situational blend of the management styles. The style of management, it depends on the importance of the activity, time availability to complete it, understanding of the activity by your subordinates. All these factors actually decide which kind of leadership style one should use. And the same I practice. The thing is that the most preferred style of leadership for me is the democratic leadership, as all we are in a democratic country and we are used to it. And participation of every individual is very important for the growth of an organization. So obviously, if I want to describe my leadership style, it is a situational blend depending on the certain factors, as I mentioned earlier.
Right. So, being the principal of Bharti Vidyapeeth, so how do you strategize about key programs and plans for both the marketing and the administration of the college?
I think marketing has actually a recent term which has crept into educational institutes, especially when the demand and supply ratio got skewed. Then this marketing term came into educational institutes. Otherwise, educational institutes were far away from the marketing. The fact is that Bharti Vidyapeeth, which was established in year 1964 by Dr. Patan Rao Kadam, and is working in all the sectors of education. And it's an established brand for more than 50 years. So, by the grace of Dr. Patan Rao Kadam, we hardly need to go for the marketing. But the indirect style of marketing, it would be the striving for excellence and the quality education. See, almost all the institutes of Bharti Vidyapeeth, along with this institute too, we are accredited by NAC. Bharti Vidyapeeth University, which is a part of Bharti Vidyapeeth family, it is ranked by NIRF and many other accrediting agencies. So this speaks of the quality, and because of such kind of quality built into the culture, educational culture of Bharti Vidyapeeth, I think we hardly need to go for any specific strategy for the marketing, but rather we focus on the quality, and quality speaks itself. Striving for excellence in quality education is our primary concern. And the stakeholders of this Bharti Vidyapeeth, maybe our students, parents, industry, they are our brand ambassadors, and that gives us the success in all respects. So, striving for excellence for the quality in education, this is what is the simple principle that we follow for the administration.
All
every stakeholder is associated with us should be satisfied, and that's the most important. Thank you.
So, sir, if I may ask you, how does the curriculum of Bharati Vidya Peeth ensure the best practices of the industry? Or to rephrase it, how do we get our students to be industry ready?
Right. See, actually, when students come to any educational institute, let it be Bharati Vidya Peeth or any other institute, they we can find out there are about two or three things, in his mind. Some of the students, they are looking for placement immediately after their graduation. Some of the students, they are looking for higher education after the graduation. And some of the students, they look for some entrepreneurship or starting their own startups. Now, for this, if we go for that, is a specific skill sets are required. Like the technical skills are required, interpersonal skills are required, or certain career-centric training or the skills are required. Now, particularly, this institute is affiliated to Savitribai Phule Pune University. And as everyone knows, that this university is a very old university established long back. And the world university ranking of this institute is somewhere in the band of 500, 1 to 600. Because that particular ranking, they declare the bands and the exact position after 100. So we can say it's in the band of 500, 1 to 600. This is also an accredited university consistently performing very well and among the top 10 universities of the India. Now, the fact is that this university is also ranked by NIRF. The fact is that earlier, the approach of all universities, including Pune University, the curriculum revision used to take place almost after 8 to 10 years, whereas the technology is changing at a very fast rate, and obviously education sector has to keep pace with the changing technology. And therefore, the curriculum of university that is updated every 4 years now, since last 2-3 years. It was in 2012, it was revised, then in 2015, and in 2019, it was revised. And rather, for the next session, the next revision, the university is geared up. I am especially mentioning this. The reason is that the university is continuously upgrading their curriculum. But as I said earlier, this upgraded curriculum helps in only one factor, that is the technical skills of the students. Whereas the other skills, interpersonal skills, career-centric trainings, etc., this needs to be taken care of at the institute level. And therefore, we have a very structured program for all the 4 years of the student. In year one, we train the students for the communication skills, group discussions, written communication, oral communication, etc. So that part is covered in first year. At the second year level, we train the students for certain analytical skills or beyond that, some professional skills. At third year, we go for training of the students for some specific domain so that it will be helpful from them to build their career. And this is how the curriculum is being continuously updated. We are taking care of their interpersonal skills, career-centric activities, and therefore, it is definitely going to help the students not only to be ready for industry, but even if they wish to go for self-employment or go for higher education, they will get good assistance in this industry.
Right. I'm sure the aspiring students will find motivation from the thoughts you just shared. So moving on, sir, what is your opinion on the new education policy of 2020? And how do you think it will benefit the students to become corporate ready?
Let me correct one thing. The thing which is very popularly called as New Education Policy 2020 is definitely a new policy, but the correct name is the National Education Policy 2020. If we go through this document of National Education Policy, we can find out certain things. I'm now only focusing on the part which is related to higher education. The interdisciplinary, holistic, flexible and skill-centric policy is the new education or the National Education Policy 2020. In nutshell, I can talk about this. Because of this, students are going to get multiple points of entry to the institute and multiple points of exit. Today, the fact is that if some student, maybe of engineering, maybe of medicine, if he leaves his college for some or other reason, maybe after first year or second year, the qualification he has only 12th standard pass. Whereas in the proposed policy, there will be multi-entry point and multi-exit point. That means, suppose it may happen something like this. Maybe after second year of engineering, he may get some certification or diploma that he can use for his employment or for further activities. Maybe after, say, 3 years taking some job experience, he wants to come back and continue to pursue his degree program, he will be able to do so. Another feature is that there will be a national level credit bank. And in fact, this is a very good provision for the from the student's point of view. And at the same time, it's a big challenge for the educational institute in coming future. Because of this, the credit bank, all his credits will be stored over there. And when he goes to some other institute, he can or other university, all his credit will be transferred as it is. So at any point of time, he can switch from one institute or from one university to another university without any problem. Now, here comes the point that he can pursue his education anywhere in India as per his need and choice and expertise of that particular institute, every individual institute has to come up with a strategic plan to excel in certain areas. Further, because of multiple exit point and entry points, he will be able to tailor his own learnings. If he is working in one particular industry, he can take up the courses from, again, the universities or the institute which has got proved excellence, and he can train himself for the area where he is supposed to excel in the in his profession. So that means he will be ready for the corporate to much better extent compared to what scenario is today. And at the same time, he can upgrade himself as per the changing technology. And this is going to prove much beneficial for him for his career. Thank you.
Right, sir. So moving on to the next question. So what do you see as some of the biggest challenges for the higher education sector in general and for Bharatiya Vidyapeeth College of Engineering specifically moving forward?
Okay. You know, the entire scenario of education sector is going to change in the next 10 years because of National Education Policy 2020. Earlier, it was specifically limited to the employability of the student, creativity and innovation were the key qualities which were expected by the industry among the students. This we are doing it, no doubt about it. But along with this now, there is challenge from the entry of the foreign university and many of the private universities which are coming up in India in collaboration with foreign universities. And the certain online skill programs, skill development programs are also available. Those programs, these features, we can say, of the forthcoming years is going to affect a lot on the educational institutes. And that is going to be a big challenge for the educational institutes and definitely to us as well. So the rule of survival of the fittest will be the key role to decide the survival and the growth of the institute in near future. So basically, we need to prepare the students so that they will be acceptable globally. We cannot plan only for the local needs, sectoral needs. We need to think globally and has to prepare our students to take up the global challenges.
Right. So what are some of the plans that you're currently designing or, you know, will be designing in the near future for Bharatiya Vidyapeeth College of Engineering, International Affairs or International Students?
We believe in the holistic development of the students and the other stakeholders. And for this, you already, this institute is NAC accredited. Our stakeholder industry is also equally important, and in last 2-3 years, we are geared up to have the strong industry interaction. And I am glad to share with you that AICT CII, Confederation of Indian Industries, they rank the institute based on their performance and interaction with the industry. They have given us the silver ranking for our collaboration with the industries. We focus on the internship of the students. 284 students in last year could take up the internship. Unfortunately, because of this COVID pandemic, our summer season of internship could not take place. So otherwise, this number would have at least doubled. So that would be a good number. We focus on the innovation. Recently, we have received 4.5 star ranking out of 5 by MHRD. We are promoting startups on the campus. 4 startups are already functioning. We have focused on the innovation as well. And for that, we have trained our students to file the patents. Because normally, at least when we studied, the patent was something considered as a very challenging thing. And instead of facing that problem, knowing the modalities to file a patent, one used to keep away from the IPR and like that. So we trained our students so that they can file their patents at their own and need not depend on consultants and all that, because then it proves very costly. And again, in last 2 years, our students, right from first year to final year, they have filed around 35 patents. See, this is the background that I can say is being prepared to face the coming challenges. Now, for going globally or internationally, we have collaboration with North Carolina A&T State University, USA. As of now, our 6 faculty members, they are either completing their or pursuing their PhD there. 1 or 2 faculty members have already completed PhD from North Carolina A&T State University. 1 faculty member, she has completed her MS at North Carolina University and is back on the campus. So she is a good source for us, for the students as well, to know more about the foreign education and get admissions in North Carolina University. And this is, as of now, it is limited to this university. We are going to increase this base. This is for the higher education. From internship point of view, presently I am speaking with 2 companies from Japan, and shortly we are likely to sign MOU. So students will get facility, a benefit to undertake internship in Japan as well. And specifically, I have mentioned to them that the students who are coming to this institute, and another reason is obviously the currency, Indian currency is not that strong as that of Japan. So it will not be affordable for the students to stay there for more period and take the benefits of internship. So they are ready to take care of all the living expenses and the boarding expenses in Japan itself. It will not be a burden to students. What will be the burden to students to travel from here to Japan and return back? So I have mentioned this to them, and they have agreed upon it. So shortly we'll be signing MOU with them. So from on these lines, we are trying to extend this MOUs with the foreign universities, with the industries. We are doing it with Indian industries, no doubt, and many of them are MNCs as well. So that, again, additional benefit the students are likely to get. So we are definitely gearing up to bring this institute at the international level. Thank you.
Right, sir. So before we wind up this interview, so one last question for you. I mean, sir, any suggestions or any advice that you would like to give to the current youth or to the aspiring students?
Yes, I don't know how many of the students do like the advice or suggestions, but definitely I would like to share that every student while coming to the engineering education, the first thing or the first confusion they have is that which branch is to be selected. If the best engineers are always required irrespective of the branch, well, I do advise the students that don't get confused, don't get driven by the peers, their friends, because they keep on saying now there is a huge demand for ENTC, huge demand computer and all that. But the fact is that for every branch of engineering, a particular skill sets are required, particular qualities are required. So instead of going driven by peers, their friends, or some family friends, it is better to analyze oneself that what qualities he has and how it matches with the quality requirements of the particular job profile. In a couple of days, admission process to first year is likely to start. We are working with some psychologists because Bharti Vidyapeeth is a multidisciplinary educational institutes. Presently, we are in talk with some psychologists and we are designing the tests so that the student can analyze himself about the qualities he has, and he will be able to make a decision to which branch of engineering he should opt for. So the first thing is that I will advise to the students, don't get driven by the peers or the friends or the family friends in making a decision which branch of engineering he should opt for. He should first of all think of himself, think of his own qualities, and then take a decision that in which branch he should go. The second thing is that right from the first year, he should plan for his own holistic development. That is very important. I mentioned that technical skills, interpersonal skills, some career-centric skills are required. So again, analyze oneself and work on that. Because this 4 years of engineering course is the golden period of life. If you work hard during this with a clear-cut understanding of himself or herself and develop the required qualities which are required, so that is very important. There is one story, many of us know that the task of cutting a tree was given to two candidates. One candidate immediately started working on the tree. He started to cut it using the axe. Whereas the other candidate, he took some time in sharpening his axe and then he took up the task of cutting the tree. Obviously, the one who took time to sharpen his axe was the winner. He could finish the job earlier. These 4 years of engineering is this particular is the same time where you are supposed to sharpen your axe. That means you are required to sharpen your skills, which are required in your future. So this is what is very important, and not enjoying in the institute, only enjoying in the education is not recommended. At the same time, they should need to take clear efforts on their skill sets. This is what is most important key to success, in my opinion. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for keeping aside your valuable time and sharing your thoughts on the Thoughts on Education Initiative. I'm sure that the thoughts you shared on this platform today will be deeply insightful and motivational to students, both aspiring and current students. So thank you once again, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.